related to just an ugly incident situation that took place at our middle school today. And I'm going to try to give you some of the basic information and then open it up so anybody who has a question, including our families that are here tonight, going to clarify and add to anything that we can. So this afternoon, roughly 3:30, a parent came into the office at John Knight Middle School and reported to the administrative staff there about an Instagram post that was absolutely incredibly inappropriate and racially hateful that they had become aware of. Not sure how they had seen or heard about it. It might have been through their child. I'm not sure. So after just a little bit of time, the site was able to determine that these were, in fact, all John Knight Middle School students, as best they could tell. Actually, our principal, Ms. O'Connor, is included in a photograph amongst the other students. So went about the business of trying to identify the students who were included in this post. There, I think the last I heard, there was about 5 students who we hadn't been able to identify. Our staff this evening called the families of all of the students who were identified to let them know that their student was included in this post and that we would be following up with them tomorrow and beyond. So what the post consists of, roughly 20 photographs of students, and as I said, our principal, which quite obviously were taken without any knowledge of what those pictures, what was going to be done with those pictures. People are smiling, happy faces, clearly posed. None of these were, kind of on-the-sly photographs. And they were combined into this post with the message on the top of the post, "Happy Black History Month to all of the monkeys." So that language was kind of superimposed on the top part of the post. I can't share that post with you at this time because there are easily identifiable students included in it. And what I would say is if anybody has information about any of the students, could help us identify them if you haven't been contacted yet, that we would appreciate that. So, as I said in the written statement that I put out, I've been in my position for a long time and I've had a lot of things happen with students over the years, and I've never seen anything as hateful as what happened today. It's horrific. And unfortunately, issues of race and class and gender and religious faith and so many other groups of people that we have, there are things not only in Dixon and in our schools that occur where people are mistreated and victims of these thoughts, which just no person should have, and obviously we understand that they extend well beyond our confines. We're here tonight because we needed to talk about this right away. Right away. In some places, you'll see it takes a parent or community group to bring forward a concern, and hopefully, the fact that we're doing this, we got a post out within a few hours of learning it. And making this effort tonight to be able to speak with people, hopefully that conveys some sense of how absolutely unacceptable this is in our eyes, and that we're not going to let this rest. So because this post was made during school hours and on campus, we're going to be able to treat this entirely as a school-related incident. So that means that all of the education code provisions around hate and around using electronic devices for bullying and so forth, we are able to apply those. And that's what we'll be doing. At this point in time, we know of one student We suspect that there are probably other students involved, perhaps in taking the pictures and assembling this collage, this twisted collage. So that's part of what we'll be investigating here. We do have the name and grade level of the student from whom the account, from whose account this post came. So, and we are confident that, that is accurate information that we have at this point in time. We have made an effort tonight to contact all the parents of the students that we were able to identify from the post. And as I was saying before, it's difficult for us to make out some of the faces because you're just blowing up the screen and things become distorted. So again, we would welcome any families that have any information related to this incident to be able to tell us your child was involved, or children of other families, if you want. Tomorrow we're going to have additional staff available, especially on our secondary campuses, combination of additional administrators, our school resource officer from the Dixon Police Department, and some of our mental health clinicians as well. We know that there are going to be students and staff who come to the school upset and angry for the whole range of reasons that people have the right to be angry and upset. So we want to have additional adults on the campuses to help students talk about this if they're ready to. And some won't be. And one of the things, as I emailed staff earlier, is that we have to be very sensitive to what our students need tomorrow. And they might not need me being the person to talk to because they just might not identify with me as much as they would another individual. And so we're just asking staff to be really thoughtful about how they interact with our students, and more than anything, tomorrow and the days, these few days coming, just to listen. All of this makes a couple things really, really clear. While we have some done some work around equity and school climate and culture, we haven't done enough. Have not done enough. And so part of what we have to do in response to this, so student or students who engaged in this conduct are over there. The whole big picture is what do we do on behalf of all of our students in Dixon? Can we influence things beyond the boundaries of the school district to help break down some of these just really corrosive and nasty beliefs and behaviors that are out there? And I want to make sure, you know, that I'm specific that this incident is specifically and in such an ugly manner targeting African American students, and it looks like some students of mixed race. And then learning tonight that there are some potentially some students who don't meet either of those descriptions. But we know that that's not the only type of that group of students are not the only group of students who receive inappropriate treatment in Dixon, just as everywhere else. So we're really going to have to take a look at some more comprehensive and active and really assertive efforts to be able to change things. It's really what has to happen. Things just have to change. Because what happened today is just not acceptable in any way, and is you know, likely to make some students feel like they don't want to come to school. And we just can't do that to our kids. Just kids should feel safe. They should feel comfortable. They should come to a place where they feel that people believe in them, and that's about the adults to a great degree, but it's also about their peers. And we're obviously today not in that place. So I will take any questions that anybody has related to this incident situation. happy to provide some clarification. Otherwise.
What are the consequences going to be for these children?
So the consequences for hate crimes, because I'm not speaking specifically to this incident because we have a lot that we don't know at this point. So for this type of electronic bullying, for the hate speech, the education code allows suspension and up to expulsion. So, and the expulsion process is one where the administrative staff makes a recommendation and then the governing board makes the determination of whether or not a student is expelled. I'll tell you, and again, don't know how many students and don't know what each of their involvement is in this situation. You know, just feeling more and more like it's not one student. While, you know, I've seen instances of violence, you know, across my years. Times students had weapons, dealing drugs, etc. This is the most extreme incident that I've been connected to in any way about this type of speech, about these types of actions with regards to race. Nothing close before. The absolute disregard that was shown in this post, never anything like it. So I can tell you that standing here today as the superintendent of schools, our intent is to follow the rules, to investigate this properly, to apply all the law, and to enforce it to the maximum degree that we can.
What implications will be made to address the cultural awareness and the sensitivity to that?
Yes, so one of the things we've made, I would say, small steps in growing in that area as we've done some work around equity. I think there's two places to start. One is with your staff. And there are, you know, we've engaged with people to too small a degree right now with regards to culturally relevant teaching, to culturally relevant practices, to helping staff become aware of and then respond to students based on their cultural differences. That's, I think, an area of clear growth for us, right? And we've had, you know, while we've had some other incidents, we could talk about those, Maya. Again, I've never seen anything at this level. So, and what we're talking about here cannot be fixed just by school staff working with kids. It's going to take parents, families, the community on a broader level. You know, the superintendent can't walk around and say, "Hey, stop talking like that" or "stop thinking like that." It has to be a much more widespread effort where our families and our students are at the center of it. Right? So exactly what that looks like right now, I couldn't tell you, but we've been looking at some consultants for some time to come in and do that work with staff first. But tomorrow we're going to have a bunch of kids come to school, many of whom will be upset by this, even if they weren't targeted with it. Many will come and, you know, kind of have the, it doesn't really affect me. And some will come with the, what's the big deal? And what we have to do is target all three of those groups of students, right? Moving kids from the middle into that mindset of being active, being leaders with regards to how students see each other and interact with each other. And that piece around the adults as well. Other questions? Take comments too, if you.
Will there be an education plan in place to teach kids that the severity of incidents like this?
Yes. We'll, you know, we have, I believe, a couple of days here, tomorrow and Friday, where our primary effort is going to be on helping students process this to some degree. We do have our mental health clinicians who have some training and experience in these types of incidents, although at the same time, I don't know that any of them have had, you know, firsthand experience in dealing with this this type of situation that they've been a part of. So there's some materials and some training and background there that we're going to utilize in these first couple of days. But we're also going to have to, and it seems, especially at our middle school, really have some targeted, both small and larger group, and larger probably being like one classroom at a time, some of the smaller group just being a few kids, being able to sit and talk and help us know better than we do now what they need, and tailoring our efforts specifically to what they need. You can go and buy a curriculum, kind of the A to Z on on how to do this work, and I like any curriculum that's A to Z, whether it be for math or language arts or whatever, there's pieces that don't fit. So we do have some people in the area who we have participated with in other professional development. A number of our administrators last year attended a 7 or 8 session training through the Association of California School Administrators. And through that, we got to know some consultants who are the kind of people who we're looking at bringing in to assist in this. We clearly have a lot of work to do, and we clearly need some outside expertise to assist us in it. Anything else that I can answer for anybody?
Are these kids going to be on campus tomorrow? Allowed back on campus?
No. Can't elaborate, but no.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, then we don't know. You said you can.
So at this point in time, yeah, I'll clarify. So the one student who we have identified at this point in time will not be on campus tomorrow. There will be a really intensive effort to identify other students who participated in this. And, you know, we've got a good partner in the Dixon Police Department. And to what degree, if any, there could be penal code violations here, I don't know. I had a text and email exchange with Chief Thompson just a little while ago. Making sure that he had our information as it stands this evening, and we'll be coordinating with them tomorrow. But typically with this type of situation, Officer Malone would sit with us as we interview students and try to find out what the complete story is here.
Our parents are going to know if you're interviewing our students, because I would like to be there.
Yeah. So in this type of situation, what we'll typically try to do is say, you know, call a student into the office, said, you know, are you comfortable in speaking to me alone? Would you like to let mom or dad know and have them come down? So we'll extend that, especially when a student is a target of behavior and not someone we suspect may have been a source of a problem, whether this one or another one. Kids are unsettled and they're scared and they're hurt, and it's not okay for us to say, you know, mom, dad, we'll let you know how this went, when there's a role for us. Again, if we're going to improve here, it has to be through partnership. If there's nothing else, I'd like to sit down with you now. Okay, if you turn the camera off and just talk a little bit about, you know, I want to get, excuse me, the information from those of you who said your child was included, and make sure we have that. But also, and again, I wish I could tell you more than I can tell you tonight, but just that, this is going to be a huge focus in figuring out exactly what happened here in the short term, and then doing all we can to make sure we don't see something like this again. So thank you, Mr. KCRA. Sorry, I don't know your name. And I'm going to move a table.